Okay, we're going to do the eyes today. Now, I've laid out a bunch of heads here just to show you that although they might be different sizes, they all start out basically the same way, from the big one here. You see the eye platform there? That's the important thing. They're all there. Now, here's one with a little different expression with his eyes opened wide. But again, we have the egg or the circular platform for the eye. Here's another one. Another one, they all have that. Here's a small one. It's really a good head. I did this 10, 12 years ago. Just saving it till I find out the best way to use it. It's going to be a mountain man, but I just haven't really decided on how to use it. So anyway, let's just move all these to the side. Get back to our figure here. Moved inside today because it's cold outside. All right, so let's first sketch in his eyebrow. And in doing that, we're also going to sketch in the platform for the eye, which is there. Basically, what we're doing is we're drawing in the skull opening for the eye socket. Just like that. Now that goes up a little there, that's because his eyebrows raised, but if it wasn't, we'd just draw it in the same size as that one over there, okay? Alright, so now starting here, well first of all, if you're using this knife, go strop it really good, because you're going to do some real critical detail here and you want a real sharp knife. So we're going to start right there. And we're going to follow that line. Notice I keep my knife at a slant right around to that point right there and stop. And we're going to come in here like this, up to that. If we do it right, everything should just fall out of there like that. Each time you go back, each time you have to go back, you end up with things like that. Or things like that right there. That's why, ideally, you want to get it in one pass. Okay, now the lower part, we do it just the opposite. Well, we don't do it the opposite, I guess. Again, at a slant, steeper slant this time. Just curve right around to the other. And the reason I say it a more angled slant is because we want this lower part to flow more into the face. Here, see, a more even transition from here to here than from here to that area there. This is deep. Do that deep because your eyebrow hangs over your eye. Now I gotta find the cut. Okay, there it is. Let me just cut down to that. Yeah, that's what you want right there. Nice clean chip. Okay, now we're gonna do it on this side over here. So up top here, a steeper slant, but still a slant. And then as we come down, we lay the knife down more. Down here, we're going to start with a real Now we can come back. This one's kind of deep because I did it upside down. Just like anything. I don't think you can do anything standing on your head as easy as you could standing straight up. And that's going to be tricky to get in there with that wide blade, so I'll use this to get that out. And again, each time you go back, you're going to have to contend with those fuzzies, as everybody calls them. I'll soften this one up a little. That eyebrow just a bit. Get a little more curve in this one. This will give it a more arched appearance. Like that. That cut there, you can see where his cheek comes around here like that, see? And this one comes around here like this. So this eye being distorted will have an effect on this side of the face. So we'll allow for that. Okay, I always like to put a wrinkle right here. Okay, so we got that done. Okay, now we got to figure out what we want the eyes to do. Well, just because this eye is raised up doesn't necessarily mean that that eye has to be open more. So let's just experiment here and draw a line across here. High. like that. Okay, that looks pretty good. Okay, starting right here at the junction of the nose and that eye plane, we're going to make a cut at a slight angle. And we're going to curve it down and then back again like that. And we're going to come up to that. Pencil lines. I'll start right here and just take out a little curve chip there. To give a little more shape to the eye. Now we're going to do it on the other side. So we sort of match up our position right there, slant again, bring it down. First starting to carve eyes this way, it's hard to get used to carving right side up this way and upside down that way, but that's the only way you can do it. But the more you do it, the easier it gets. So that's good. So now here I'm going to take a little chip out of there, just like I did on the other side. See what that does, it just gives a little more shape to that eye. Okay, now we're going to do the other side. Draw my line. Again, a slight slant. I carve into it. And then we carve down to it. You want to get your knife deep in the corner right there and right there. That gives you the round look to your eye. Alright, now I'm going to do it on the other side. Upside down. That's good, huh? Now, we're going to take out, we want the upper lid to overlap the lower lid. So right about here. See the cut right there? We're going to take the portion out of, from there. See the difference that made? Now we can come back up here and go just a little deeper. Makes it even more pronounced. Judy keeps knocking me on the head. Get your head out of the way. Okay, let me get my pencil lines off here. Just getting rid of that ridge that's on the eye. And I like to put a little cut right here. This is why you really need a sharp knife. Just the pressure of you laying the knife on the wood is just about what you need to get the cut that you need. See right there? Same up here. You definitely don't want to cut this way first, or that whole lid will just fall off of there. So we're cutting away from the weakest point, just like that. Then we'll come down to it, just like that. And then we'll just come across. Same thing here. You have to really be gentle up here because this whole thing can collapse at any minute. Hopefully it won't. Much easier to do on a larger head. Well, it's not impossible on a small one. Stop right there. Okay, we've got one frown line already there, so let's just get him another one here. Curve it around with this. Over here. It's another one. So there, we have our eyes now. Okay. These little hairline cuts will disappear as soon as I dunk this in underneath the water. The wood will swell back up and all those little cuts will just close right up again. So I'm not really concerned about that. So anyway, now we've got her head done. So the next step is the hat. And I'm going to go ahead and make a coal miner out of this guy because that's what we started with. So in the next video, we'll work on the hat up there. And then after that, we'll go on with the body. So until next time, I'll talk to you later.